Hi, welcome back to our third installment of Swiss SuperLuminova. We're diving deep into how it works, how it should be used, and how it impacts us as watch lovers. We are delighted to be joined here with Albert Zeller. He is the CEO of Swiss SuperLuminova, and my name is Stephen Mansfield. I'm one of the co-founders of SNGLRTY Watch. We're delighted to be working closely with Swiss SuperLuminova to ensure that we can offer a huge range of colors on all our watches at SNGLRTY Watch. So if you're interested, head over to our website, www.singularitywatch, S-N-G-L-R-T-Y, drop all the vowels, and you've got it, singularitywatch.com. We'll look forward to hearing from you soon. But it's time now to dive into the technical details. We're going to get into the nitty-gritty. How does that material, the ceramic material that we learned in the previous installment, how does that ceramic material, how does it store the light and then know when to release the light for us in our watch? Albert, tell us.
You can imagine it as a little light storage battery. It works like that you have some different energy levels in your material itself. Energy levels, see it as levels in the skyscraper, or different floors in the skyscraper. You have a ground floor, but there's also like a floor somewhere up in the 50th floor. Imagine an electron to be a little balloon. You take the balloon, you walk up the stairs to the 50th floor, and your legs will probably hurt. That's because you had to invest some energy to lift up that balloon to that storage. In SuperLuminova, it works like that the energy put into a system is UV light, invisible light, to lift up the electrons to a higher energy level. Afterwards, in that floor or in that energy level, there are different rooms. Those are the levels you can see on the right side there. So the electrons can jump in between the different rooms or levels, and after a certain time, they will fall back down to the ground floor. Falling down means that's a loss of energy. And in the case of SuperLuminova, it's visible light, which is emitted by the crystal. Means you put in UV light to charge the crystal, to put up the electrons to a higher level. You storage the energy, and after a certain time, it will be emitted by visible light.
Does the performance of the Luminova deteriorate over time? You know, with my phone, it starts off great when it's new, but over a few years, the battery starts to decline in its performance. Do we have the same problem with Luminova?
You can repeat this process unlimited times. Means if you give your ransom your watch, it will have the same performance as on the first day. There's no half-life time, same performance over decades.
Okay, so the Luminova needs to be charged with a light source. What is the best light source to use to make sure we get the brightest luminous performance or the best luminous performance?
There are different light sources existing on this planet or in this solar system. There's like a living room lamp, which you can see, it's a few hundred lux in maximum. And there's also a rather big lamp on the outside, which is called the sun, which goes up to more than 100,000 lux. The sun will also let you become red if you stay for too long in the sun without any sunblocker, whereas this probably won't happen in a living room because the energy emitted by a normal lamp is way lower. This is also the reason why SuperLuminova can be charged very fast with the strong light sources, especially UV light sources, whereas in a living room, it will take a little bit longer and will never be fully charged. Means if you can charge the watch on sunlight, this will bring you the best performances.
Okay, so I think I've got a good understanding, and I hope everyone else has got a good understanding of how the Luminova itself works. Now, from a personal perspective, I really want to understand how to apply it to a watch. So, what's the best way to ensure that when it's applied to the watch, it's applied the right way to get the best performance possible?
There's a very crucial point which is often missed and would not be too hard to really establish. You have to imagine every single grain of Swiss SuperLuminova as a little light battery. If you have a few light batteries on a pile, this gives you a little bit of light. If you really stack a lot of light batteries on a pile, this will give you a lot of light, which is seen afterwards in the dark. So the goal is to maximize the amount of Swiss SuperLuminova on a watch. The question is now, how can it be done? There's different ways to increase the quantity of pigments on your watch. One thing is to expand the surface, but that's a question of design. Not everybody likes a full face Swiss SuperLuminova dial. And another possibility is to go a little bit more into the height. Means if you increase the layer thickness, you can also place more pigments onto the same surface, which will give you a brighter performing luminous deposit.
Can you illustrate that for us, please?
If you go to the right side here, you can see then we've been doing some measurements with that. In this case, we did it with the Swiss SuperLuminova GLC3 grade A. That's like a middle performing luminous pigments, which is not colored. Means this should also give rather good performance compared to the uncolored one. There's an ISO norm, that's the 17514 norm, which defines how to measure the luminous decay of a watch component. Works like this, that you have a sample. You charge it for 20 minutes with 400 lux with the D65 lamp. As you can remember, 400 lux, that's more or less the light conditions you have in the normal living room. After these 20 minutes of activations, you put it into a measurement device and you start measuring the emitted energy of light. This is measured in nanocandela. And you can see that the more material you apply to a watch component, the longer or the flatter the decay curve will be. The ISO norm defines that 39 nanocandela is the visibility border. So you start measuring your compound as long as it's on 39 nanocandela, and that's the time visible in the dark. So you see, you can influence the time pretty easy by just applying a little bit more pigment. As you compare, for example, the one and the double amount, 2 milligrams, you can almost double the time.
So, if we don't have any option around increasing the surface area or increasing the thickness of the print, are there any other options we can consider?
We recommend to do engravings. Engravings, you won't see a difference from above, but it gives you the possibility to create a certain volume to store the pigments and also more light. On the right side, you see a little test we've been doing about that. We've been producing three dials, same design, pretty simple in that case. And you see that we did different engraving depths. One was 50 micrometer, the other one was 150 micrometers, and the last one 300 micrometers. And you can directly see the first one is visible for around, let's say, 400 minutes with the 50 micrometers. And if you go for 150 micrometers, you're already up at 900 minutes, which is a little bit longer than a usual night. If you go even deeper, you see 1400 minutes. That's by far more than a night. So the watch will be according to the ISO norm, better visible than, or longer visible than a regular night.
Is there a maximum depth that we can apply Luminova to? I mean, is it? I can't imagine that the light that's charging the Luminova can penetrate into the middle of the application if it's very thick.
There's also a certain border. That comes from that if you have a certain layer of Swiss SuperLuminova, it is very easy to charge the pigments on top. Whereas the ones at the bottom, it's harder for the UV light to get down there to charge the pigment. And afterwards, also the emitted light should somewhere get out. It's easier for the ones on top. Therefore, we recommend to go, let's say, up to 300 micrometers, where the activation is more or less linear. Afterwards, the curve gets flatter. You can still win some luminous performance, but it's not in a rather linear way anymore. Additionally, you probably won't find a dial where you have like a 1 millimeter thick printing on it. It's just a question of the dimensions of a watch too.
Are there any other options we should be thinking about when we're applying the Luminova to ensure we get the best performance?
So what can you do if you cannot exchange the surface, or also cannot do any engravings anymore? Then you should think about the quality of the light battery. By quality of light battery, I mean like that's the quality of the SuperLuminova. When we started in 94 with the production of the standard grade material, that was standard back then. But over the years, we've been doing research, and we launched the grade A quality. And you see on the right side, grade A has a flatter decay curve, means it will last longer in the dark with the same amount of pigment supplied. Now we created ourselves a little problem by ourselves, because we called the best quality back then grade A. And if you find a newer material, better performing material, you cannot call it grade B. That would not sound as nice. So therefore, we decided to call an even better quality, best performing quality at the moment on the market, grade X1. Grade X1 is way easier to activate, means you have to spend less time under the sunlight to charge the pigments, and it will have a flatter decay curve, which will give you on the long term, means at 4 o'clock in the night, for example, a way better readability of the watch.
Thank you very much for joining us today. I hope that's been illuminating for you. We're really enjoying doing this. We've loved the feedback we've received. Please send through any questions. We've got another 2, possibly 3 of these to go. We're still working on the full schedule. So put your comments below. Please sign up for our newsletter at blog.singularity.watch. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and do check out our website at singularitywatch.com. Don't forget, for Singularity, drop all the vowels. And in the meantime, see time differently. Thanks very much.